woman from his past.
We spent every day together, especially in the summertime.
Has an uncertain future.
Cancer. I'm dying, Sam.
How come you never mentioned her?
I didn't think it was that important.
I need your help, Sam. I have no one else.
Anything.
Candles on Bay Street starts right now on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries.
Those feet.
Does that mean?
Yeah, he's gonna be a big one.
Wow.
What do you say?
Thank you.
We just take good care of him. Bring him back in a couple of weeks for vaccinations, okay?
Hi, Lydia.
Hi.
Bye now.
Bye-bye, thanks.
Which one did she take?
The floppy-eared one. How you doing?
Good, almost finished.
Wanna go see the Taj Mahal?
I'll go anywhere with you, baby.
Oh, you picked my favorite one. If I might be so bold, I called him Bentley. Get out of there.
All right, all right. How am I supposed to know when my next appointment is?
Oh, it's in a half an hour. But it's Elmer. If he's on time, I'll do cartwheels.
And I'll like to see that.
No, you wouldn't.
Got it?
I thought they'd be further along.
We've had a lot of rain.
Hey, Sam. Lydie.
Hi.
What's up? Came to take a look. What do you think?
Nice hole.
Well, we've had a lot of rain.
That's what I said.
Can't dig in the rain. You guys in a hurry? You want to fill this house up with some babies?
Yep.
Someday.
Yeah. We get some good weather, we'll be fine.
Sure.
Sheep and then a checkup on Joe's pregnant cow.
Okay. Call me when you're headed home.
Bye.
Campbell's hound lacerated his paw. Did you find it?
No. Where is it?
Tiny hairline fracture, right above the joint.
Hmm.
You don't need reading glasses, do you?
No.
Just wondering.
Hey.
Hey.
What's up?
Just passing by. Thought I'd stop in. Busy?
Yeah.
Don't mean to interrupt.
I saw her.
How come you didn't tell me?
I was on a call.
I saw her too down at the gas station.
Hi, Ross.
Need some help?
Elmer just showed up, and I've got the Campbell dog.
Elmer's appointment was yesterday.
That's Elmer.
All right, you take him, would you? I'll take the Campbell dog.
What brings you here?
He needs a distemper.
I'll catch up with her.
Doofus. Who's that?
Belonged to an old friend of mine.
What was his name?
Ben. He asked me to keep him for him because he didn't have room.
Can I play him? Can I play him really loud?
Yeah. Just do me a favor and wait till I get downstairs. Let her rip!
What'd you think?
A what?
The movie.
Oh, I liked it.
You did not.
Why do you say that?
You kept looking at your watch.
I guess I did, didn't I?
Sam, where are you?
I'm right here. Oh, that ought to do it, Walter. Just give it a week or so.
I can't pay you the next week, Sam.
Don't look at me.
We know where you live. Oh, thanks.
Your 3:30 canceled.
Well, I guess we'll run out to Joe's, check on that cow.
Weren't you just there yesterday?
Yeah. She's very close.
You're acting like an expectant father. Are you gonna hand out cigars?
Hi. Your mom around?
No. She went to the store.
Old friend of your mother's. I used to live next door. This is my house right here. That was my room right there. So you're quite the basketball player. About that. Well, I'll just... come around another time.
Okay, Joe, I'll tell him. Okay.
Where's Sam?
Oh, I don't know. He said he was gonna go check on Joe Lieber's cow.
Maybe she's already had her calf.
Well, she did. But Sam wasn't there.
Where'd you go?
Well, had to go check on Joe's cow.
Joe called. The cow had her calf. He said you weren't there.
I didn't make it. So.
How come?
Is Sam, but... Oh, Sam, someone wants to see you.
Right.
I think we've solved the mystery.
Not dark skin.
Hi, Sam. Kind of expected a bigger hello.
I'm surprised to see you.
Trooper, is this the guy who stopped by?
Mm-hmm. I heard that you went down. I'm just... surprised.
So, you already met my son, Trooper?
No, not officially.
I'm Sam.
Hi. Dude, what do you do when someone offers you their hand? What else?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I told Troop that you were a veterinarian, and he wanted to come by right away because he loves animals.
Is that right? Well, I might know a puppy who needs a home. Suppose you'd be interested?
Please, Mom.
Wow. You have to take care of him.
I will. Come on.
All right.
All right. I'll lay right here.
Do you even know how to take care of a dog? What are you gonna do?
Made a deal.
A gummy bear. You want another?
Okay.
I'm Rosemary.
Trooper.
Ah. Oh. See.
Oh. What's his name?
Oh, it's up to you.
Thanks, Sam, I think.
Just be good to him. Bring him back here. Whenever he needs anything, it'll be on the house.
I'll take care of him. Hey.
Oh. Hi, Alice. Go ahead and take her on back to number two. I'll be there in a minute.
Alice? It's me, Dee Dee.
Dee Dee Michaud?
Yeah, and this is my son, Trooper.
Well, hello, Trooper. Why, my goodness, I haven't seen you since...
Yeah, about 13 years.
Are you just visiting?
No, I'm here to stay.
Well, good for you.
Sam, I can see that you're busy. We'll catch up later.
Okay.
Okay.
Trooper!
Thanks for the puppy.
You're welcome.
Bye, Rosemary.
Bye.
Give him a good home.
I will.
Why didn't you just tell me the truth at the office?
I didn't want Rosemary gossiping.
About what?
About Dee Dee.
What about Dee Dee?
Oh, just nothing.
You were worried she'd gossip about nothing?
We were friends. We grew up together. I mean, I've known the girl since I was 3 years old. She and Ross and I hung out. I mean, she was fun.
Fun?
We were just friends, okay?
People gossip about friends here.
It's a small town, Lydia. I mean, what do you know about small towns? You grew up in Boston.
Oh, I don't know, Sam. Why don't you tell me what it's like to grow up in a small town? Tell me about your friend.
What do you mean?
I don't know. What's she like?
She was a free spirit, okay? Everybody in town knew her. Me, I was this shy little kid afraid of his own shadow. Once there was this kid who was sort of the neighborhood bully. He stole my baseball cards. Now, I pretended that it didn't matter, but it mattered to Dee Dee. She found him. She beat him up, and she got him all back for me.
Oh, that was nice of her.
You know, she didn't even care about what people thought about her. In the ninth grade, she gets caught smoking in the school bathroom. The principal takes her into his office before he can even get a word in. She offers him a cigarette.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, on grad graduation day, she ran off with Bobby Langford.
You pass me the olive oil? Is she the one you were going to give your class ring to?
Who told you that?
Ross. A long time ago.
Yeah, she was the one. Pass me the pepper.
Not until you tell me.
Nothing to tell.
Try me.
I was planning on giving her my class ring the night before graduation. We were standing out on her porch, and I had it out. I had it in my hand. I'm about to give it to her. But before I could say anything, she pops out with the news that she's going. Next day, gone.
You never heard from her?
A couple of postcards. One from some small town in Kansas. Home of the world's biggest ball of twine. Ain't life a hoot, that's what it said. Nothing more.
How come you never mentioned her?
I didn't think it was that important.
That she was your first crush. I mean, if my first boyfriend came into town.
Look, I got over it. I married this woman that I am absolutely crazy about.
Really? What's she like?
You'd have to know her.
Is she pretty?
Pretty? Movie star, beautiful. Smart as a whip. Let's see, terrific veterinarian, did I mention that? Loved by people and pets alike.
I think we should ask them to dinner.
Really?
Gotta know the competition.
Trooper, Lydia.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you, too.
Trooper.
Hi, Trooper.
Hi. Hi. It was really nice to meet you.
Well, come on inside.
This is for you.
Oh, thank you. Should I open it now?
Sure.
Okay. They're lovely.
I'm glad you like them. I made them.
They're beautiful. We can use them tonight at dinner. I'm still working in the kitchen.
Oh, good. Let me help you. What are you making?
Nothing fancy. Some roast chicken, mashed potatoes, carrots.
Nut?
Okay.
Oh, I love candlelight dinners.
Me too. Maybe you'll be a customer.
A customer?
I'm gonna open up a candle shop.
Here?
Is that a bad idea?
Well, no. It's not a bad idea.
But?
Is
such a terrible liar.
He's learning.
Well, I just wonder if it's, if the town is large enough for a candle store.
Yeah, I thought of that, but I figure if I offer candle making lessons, you know, what do you think, Lydia?
Oh, I think you'll just have to try it and see.
Would you be interested?
Me? I don't have that much free time. So, how did you get interested in candle making?
Well, it started as a hobby, but then I had to make a living. And I guess I just love what candles symbolize.
Which is what?
I guess hopes and dreams and wishes. People light candles in church. They use them for prayer. Dude, you can't just eat before everybody starts.
No, it's okay. It's okay. Dig in. So, Trooper, how'd you get the nickname Trooper?
It's not a nickname. My real man.
We've traveled around so much, we're like a small theater troupe.
So you spell it with a U?
Hmm?
T-R-O-U-P-E-R.
No. T-R-O-O-P-E-R.
I gave him the name, so I figure he can spell it however he wants.
Well, not really.
Oh. Yeah, that's right, because last year you wanted to spell it with three O's.
Troop, weren't you gonna ask Sam something?
Oh, yeah. Do you have lots of animals downstairs?
We sure do.
Can I see them?
Sam, why don't you take Trooper down and show him our zoo?
Good. All right, come on, Troop. Can I call you Troop?
If you want to.
But he calls me Sam.
He's a nice boy.
Yeah. He reminds me of Sam. Shy at first, but there's a lot going on underneath.
I understand you're living in your childhood home.
Yeah. Lots of memories there.
What brings you back after all this time?
My mom died and the house was just sitting there. But mostly for Trooper, I keep boring him with all my stories of how great it was to grow up here. How'd you and Sammy?
Oh, at Cornell. In vet school.
He always wanted to be a vet.
I guess you knew him pretty well.
Yeah, hard not to. He lived next door. We spent every day together, especially in the summertime. So you moved back here after vet school?
I was a city girl pining for country life. Slower pace, nicer people. You must have a lot of friends here.
Yeah, I guess I do. But you married my best one.
Well, this is where we operate.
Is there a lot of blood and stuff?
Sometimes. How's that puppy doing, by the way?
He's fine.
What do you call him?
Chewbacca.
Nice name. How'd you come up with that?
He tried to eat my shoelaces. Are all these yours?
No, they all belong to other people. Except this little guy. Actually, this is Chewbacca's brother. Wanna see him?
Sure. Do you get to play with him?
It's kind of hard to find the time.
Excuse me.
Thank you. Dinner was so good.
You're welcome.
I'm going to walk you guys home?
Nah, you're the way. Don't bother.
Go ahead, Sam.
I'll be right back.
Got it?
Yep.
Enjoy.
Remember that bike I bought with berry picking money?
When you sold it to Jimmy Fallon.
I wish I had it back. I'd give it to Troop.
So what do I have?
Nothing. Just pure nostalgia.
Nostalgia. Coming from the woman who could not wait to get out of here.
It's funny, isn't it?
Yes, it's true. You never appreciate what you have until it's gone.
Hey, Trooper, this is CJ's, that place I told you about.
Same old place. Same old geezers. Except now I'm one of them. Go ahead, hold on. Where's his dad?
Tripp never knew his dad. He was less than a year old when Bobby left.
Bobby?
Yeah.
Huh. Where'd he go?
Alaska. He never really wanted kids.
I can't say that I'm surprised.
Sam, is that a polite way of saying I told you so? How about you and Lydia? Any plans for kids in the future?
Kids? Yeah. Someday. Just be sure.
Sure about what?
We're financially secure, they're ready, time to devote to families.
You haven't changed a bit, Sam.
I guess not.
I wish I were more like you.
Never thought I'd hear you say that.
Oh, shut up. I have learned something in the last 13 years. Last few nights, I can't sleep. I wake up. I go to my window and look out at your window. It used to make me so comfortable just knowing you were there. I'm so sorry, Sam. I'm sorry I fell off the map. Bobby and I got married right away. Trooper came a year later. I'm not making excuses, but I do really apologize.
No name.
It's kind of hard for Troop, you know. Moving again to a new place. Just gotta make new friends.
He seems like a great kid. You know, in the meantime, I could use some help around the clinic. Someone to feed and look after the animals.
He would love that. Good. Thank you, Sam. I have to make trips back and forth to Boston. This is perfect.
What are you doing in Boston?
Oh, I have to pick up supplies. Lydia seems great.
Yeah, she is great. I guess I got lucky. I offered to let Trooper help at the clinic. I hope you don't mind.
No, it's fine. It'll be good for him. And good practice for you.
You okay about tonight?
Yeah, it wasn't as awkward as I imagined. She seems nice enough.
Now, don't be nervous, Naomi.
just the entire fate of the game.
Oh. This isn't over.
Better luck next time, sweetheart.
Excuse me.
Go. It's your turn.
We'll get him next time.
Sorry about that.
How's the house coming?
It's just a hole.
At the moment. Rick's as slow as molasses. It took him a year to do my Uncle Ned's place.
He's careful, and Ned has a great house.
Oh, and Sam likes careful.
Come to think of it, Sam, too. You better push them both, Lydia.
What's the hurry?
Funny you should ask. Hey, CJ, you got anything to read while we're waiting?
Oh, you weren't sleeping through that, were you?
I'm sorry, I missed it.
Were you sleeping, were you?
Mom. What? What are these?
What?
These. Where'd you find them?
Mm-hmm. In the drawer in the kitchen.
That's Sam.
That's Sam?
He's so serious.
Mm-hmm. He's kind of chubby. Who's this?
Dad. Can I keep it?
Sure.
Here, put these back.
So, this is 154 degrees in here.
Oh. What?
Yeah, but don't worry. You can stick your finger in here, and it kind of feels good. Okay. You won't get hurt. Okay. The key to making candles is you can't hurry. You have to have patience. When I use that word with my son, he rolls his eyes. But I guess that's payback for all the times I did that to my mom. Okay, so each of us needs to take a look.
Thank you.
You want to hold it in the middle and just keep it apart so that it doesn't get stuck together. Dipping candles are made a pair at a time. And dip the wick into the heated wax.
How long do you leave it in?
Just trust your gut. It's kind of like cooking without a recipe.
A recipe? What's that?
So you want to put it in for like, I don't know, 3 seconds and then keep it out for about 3 seconds. And then we're going to cool them off for about 3 minutes. Uh-huh. I know that they look kind of skinny.
Skinny? What's that?
So he said, go ahead and buy the horses. That's what he said.
Lydia.
Hi. I was just passing by. I thought I'd...
Oh, come on in. I'm so glad that you came.
Oh, come on, Lydia. This is fun.
I'm just not so crafty.
So... when I sell my candles, I like to put a little message in each box. If you're going to be using them as gifts, you might want to do the same.
Like what?
I think candles help us explore the darkness. You know? People used to sit around campfires, keep the predators away. I think firelight
makes us feel safe.
With good friends.
You know? Do.
I mean, can you imagine? There were like half a dozen of us, all women, gathered, learning how to make these candles. It was kind of magical. Sitting there in that room, I really did feel a sense of something.
Fire hazard, probably.
I'm serious.
All right, what did you feel?
You know, for as long as I've been in this town, I've never felt a sense of that so strongly as I did tonight.
What?
A sense of community. You know, I really do like her. Much more than I thought I would.
Good.
I'll tell you the truth, I was a little jealous of her.
No kidding.
You knew?
Oh, please.
I just can't seem to get him to take his pills.
Oh, well, you just hold him like this, open his jaw, take the pill, and put it back like that.
Ready? Friedmeier's having trouble falling. I'm gonna take Trooper along.
Are you up to it?
We'll find out.
Your call, but if he faints or heaves. Sorry, we have a young helper.
Oh, Doc.
Hey, John. This is my new helper, new trooper. Fola's dropped into the birth canal. She could start to lose blood supply soon. All right, hand me my kit. Right here. Jugular groove. It's easy to find. Just trace from the jaw angle down the neck. I like to go in towards the north. I press here. See that? Increases the blood pressure in the vein. That'll take effect in a few minutes. Be less dangerous for her. And for us. Fool's in a good position. See the tiny little hooves there? Bottoms downward towards the mother's feet. Better move things along here. Apply a little traction. In my kit is a set of OB chains. They're shiny, narrow, stainless steel. Do me a favor, go get them. Go.
Ah!
Sit down. Since the loop just above the ankles, it's not gonna hurt when we pull. When she pushes, we pull. Ready? Okay. Wait for the contraction. This is the most difficult part.
Good.
All right.
Hey, thanks, Connor.
He's not been nursing in an hour. You can give me a call.
Yeah, I'll do that. I'll do that. Hey, that's some little help with you.
It sure is.
Good job.
Thanks.
Oh, thank you. Here's...
See you, John.
Take care, Doc. Trooper, right?
Yeah. I'll see you.
Did a good job.
I was a little scared.
Nothing wrong with being scared. You hung in there. Look.
Sam.
Yeah.
Did you know my dad?
Your dad?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know him really well. He was only in town for a year.
What was he like?
Well, let's see. He was a cool guy. I could say that.
My mom says he was a dreamer.
You could say that.
He left us to go to Alaska. Dreamers have to follow their hearts.
They sure do. Come on.
Kid thinks he's some sort of romantic hero. I couldn't even believe what I was hearing. A dreamer? Come on, the guy was a lowlife who abandoned them.
Maybe you were just a little jealous of him, Sam.
Liddy, the guy spent half the year he was here working on his car, the other half dealing pot. How do you romanticize that?
What if she's just protecting her son?
By lying to him?
If he were your son, what would you say?
I don't know.
I'll set it up so you can take off. All right.
Thank you. There we are.
Thanks. I'll set it up for Johnson.
Oh, please.
Shot.
Oh,
wow.
It's just a...
Hey,
we're
going to show up.
Yeah, I know. I had to drive to Boston to pick up supplies for the candle business.
Oh, Candle Mania sweeps the town.
I know. Even Rosemary joined the group.
Oh, no. Where will it end?
Maybe it won't.
Everything ends.
Hey, Siege, can we get another glass?
You know what? We have three-fourths of the band here.
What band?
Sam's band.
Oh, it wasn't my band. It was Dee Dee's.
I didn't know you had a band.
I didn't. I wouldn't have even been in the band if Dee Dee hadn't browbeaten the others at the takeaway.
What did you play?
Guitar.
You call that playing?
I don't.
Come on, Sam. People liked you.
Because you did. No, if you Ben and Ross and I would have started the band on our own, it would have lasted 5 minutes.
Yeah, I was good.
No, we were awful. Dee Dee, she was good.
When did Ben move?
A couple of years ago. Yeah. I think he moved to Dallas.
Yeah.
Do you still sing, Dee Dee?
Yeah. Drives Trooper crazy.
So how about a song?
Yeah.
Oh, we don't have Ben. Unless you want to do Ben's part.
Are you kidding?
Sam, you never sang for me.
Profoundly good reason.
People say I'm the life of the party, 'cause I tell a joke or two. Although I might be laughing loud and hearty, deep inside I'm blue. Looks out of place. If you look closer, it's easy to trace the tracks of my tears.
Hey, kid, it's too late for drums. Go to bed.
Guess what I did today?
What's that?
I delivered a horse.
All by yourself?
No, not by myself. But I helped.
Yeah?
It was so cool.
I bet.
Guess what else? Okay. Sam, he said my dad was a really cool guy.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, really cool. Just like you, Mr. Horse Doctor. Now go to sleep!
I love you, Mom.
I love you too, baby.
Here's
your friend.
Night.
Night, Angel.
See you in the morning.
Guys, give me a hand with the wall.
Set it up.
All right.
Would you like some coffee,
all right, guys.
Sir?
One, two, three. Screw it up.
Good.
Kick it in.
Slide it.
Good here.
Yeah. Looks good, Rick. When do you think the framing will be finished? Well, that's hard to say. Can you give us a guess?
Well, it's good. Not really.
Well, by fall?
Early fall or late fall?
Any fall. Depends, really. Well, if we get in the winter and the house isn't finished, then...
Yeah, that could happen.
Wouldn't that hurt the house?
Not really.
Why? I'd just prefer if it didn't fall down in a heap.
Picky, picky.
Last week, I'm not used to seeing so much of you.
Thank my assistant for that.
What's his name?
I don't have one yet. You have any ideas?
Solitaire.
Huh. Pretty good. How come you picked that one?
He doesn't have anyone to play with.
Well, then, that's what we'll call solitaire.
Honey, we're here. Come on. Quick.
It's all right, sweetie.
No, it's not, sweetheart.
He should have been there.
Honey, it's okay. Come on. Fix him right up. Keep talking. Come on, Cody.
Cody got hit by a car.
Oh, my. Here, bring him on back. Sam!
What does it look like?
Crushed lumbar vertebrae. Spinal cord damage looks irreversible. Abdomen's full of fluid, probably ruptured spleen.
Maybe I'll take Amber outside while you talk to Val.
Okay.
Sam would like to speak with you. I'll take care of him.
Hi.
Hi.
Yeah. You want to go over the x-rays?
No, that's okay.
Looks bad, Val.
Is there anything we can do?
Well, we could try to save him, but it'll be painful, and I can't give you any guarantees.
What would you do if he were yours, Sam?
I think I'd let Cody go.
Okay. I'm gonna talk to Amber.
Sure.
I'll let her come and say goodbye.
You're just gonna let him die?
Well, I'd do anything if I could save him. But he's been hurt pretty badly and he's in a lot of pain. I don't think we should let him suffer like that.
He's upstairs.
Can I speak with him? I want to explain something.
I already talked to him. He's pretty upset. What? It isn't just about the puppy, Sam.
What is it?
You know, I've been making trips back and forth to Boston. Not just pick up supplies. I've been going to a hospital.
What for?
Cancer. Non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. I'm dying, Sam. It's widespread. It's in my lymph nodes, bone marrow, liver.
You must have had treatment.
Yeah. It's just a matter of time.
How much time?
I was hoping to make it to Troop's 12th birthday, but it's moving too fast.
Does he know?
More or less. He's hoping. I haven't told him the latest. Sorry. It's really why I came home.
You say you can die here?
No, I want Trooper to live here. I need to find him a place, a family. I had this crazy idea. I built this place up in my mind, you know?
seems so magical to me. I thought all I had to do was come home. Clearly, I've learned a thing, because when I was 18, I thought everything outside of this town was magical and I just had to leave.
What about his dad?
Come on, you've never liked him. You were right. He got into drugs and dealing, and it only got worse as time went on. Well, after Troop was born, he took off for Alaska. Said he had to get work, you know. He got busted and did 2 years. And when he got out, he went right back to it. Got himself killed. And I never found out how. I chose so badly, Sam. Not just for myself, but for Troop.
Oh, Dee Dee. I'm so sorry.
I know. I know you are. I need your help, Sam. I have no one else.
Anything.
I need you to help me find a place for Troop. Please.
I just sat there with this stupid look on my face. It's like such an idiot. But I didn't know what to say.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know. Look for somebody, I guess.
But who?
I thought of John Frieden.
John Frieden?
Yeah, he likes Trooper. He's got horses.
Yeah. He's over 60 years old.
50-something, and Trooper would love being on a farm.
What does he know about raising boys these days?
They raised 2 kids.
That was over 10 years ago. And his kids are married. They have families of their own.
Oh, you think he's forgotten how?
No. But raising kids these days is a lot different than it was then.
Just a thought.
Sam?
Hmm?
I was thinking last night.
Yeah? So was I.
About what?
Going over the names of everyone I know.
We could take him.
No, we couldn't.
Why not?
It wouldn't work, Liddy. Where are we gonna put him?
We're building a house.
She doesn't think she's gonna make it that long.
We have a spare room. We can fix it up.
It's not a practical idea.
Why not?
Because we're not set up for it. We both work. Who's gonna look after him? You have to make plans for things like this. It takes time.
Oh, come on, Sam. I don't think this decision is about being practical.
Well, you've thought about this for one night, okay? It's a huge responsibility.
We've thought about having kids for a long time.
What about Val? I think Val's a good idea.
Her husband's out of work. I don't think she can.
Well, then there's the groupers. There's lots of people. Why don't we just see how she does? Maybe she's wrong. She could live for another year. She could live for 2 years. In the meantime, I've got to go inoculate the Holden pigs, okay? We'll find somebody. You ever think about having more kids?
Beyond the 2 little hellions we're raising now, you mean?
Yeah.
Why do you ask?
Just wondering.
You been talking to Naomi?
No. About what?
But you've been talking to Naomi?
That I know of. Why?
Naomi's pregnant.
Congratulations.
Thanks. I don't know how we're going to do it. We're barely making it now on two teacher's salaries.
Yeah, it's not easy.
You and Lydia thinking of that?
No, not yet.
You still remember how?
It'll come back to me.
Sam, come on. What'd you ask me for?
For Dee Dee.
Sorry I'm late.
Oh, you're never too late. We were just going to start to read our messages that we put in our gift boxes, right? Rosemary, do you want to go first?
Oh, sure. It's always me. Oh, this is for my brother-in-law, Jack, who is a real pill.
Oh, he is.
Mm-hmm. Jack, be nimble. Jack, be quick. Jack, jump over the candlestick. But don't burn your rear or you will see exactly the pain you are to me.
Not exactly what I had in mind, but it works.
You don't know Jack. Don't get excited. Remember last week when the cat, like, went through an alarm and went all over the place? It happens all the time, constantly. Besides, it's raining outside.
Doc, it's your new house.
Oh,
come on, Dennis, I'll give you a ride.
Sorry, Lydia. It's just the framing. It's not even a house yet. It's a dream. Maybe we can dream it again.
I kept the generator going to run the pump. I was afraid it was going to flood.
There must have been an electrical short. I'm sorry.
It's not your fault, Rick. It was an accident. When can we start rebuilding?
I'll have to clean this mess up. Labor Day's coming soon. I say we wait until spring. Once the bad weather starts, we're just going to have to stop. What do you think, Sam?
Sam, talk to me.
I had Rick do the house because he was so meticulous. Every nail, every joint, every angle, just so. I had him prepare the house for a hurricane.
Did I tell you that?
When was the last time there was a hurricane around here?
I don't know. 100 years. He was gonna truss the gables, reinforce the garage door, put a special adhesive on the shingles.
You can't protect against everything.
Not everything, but everything you can think of.
But you can't think of everything either. It was a freak accident.
My mother was so afraid of hurricanes.
I don't blame her.
Oh, she was afraid of pretty much everything. Every time my dad would leave on a sales trip, he'd make sure we had everything we needed. Check the tires, check the house, the rain gutters, the shutters. Do we have enough firewood? And on and on and on. And still, this woman, she was afraid.
Of what?
You name it. I used to hear her walking around the house late at night, making sure all the windows were locked. And every time I'd leave the house, my mother would ask me if I had enough money. Where are you going? Are your socks warm enough? I used to think I could actually hear her worrying. It got to a point where I didn't even want to leave the house. It was easier just to stay at home. If it hadn't been for Dee Dee, I probably would have never left the yard.
She sounds like she was a good friend to have.
She was more than that. She was my friend. My sister. Do you think I'd be a good father?
Sam, yes. Yes, I do.
And let's take him.
Are you sure? He's upstairs playing with Chewbacca.
We want to take him. When the time comes.
We're still hoping it won't.
I don't know what to say.
You don't have to say anything.
I couldn't have even hoped for this. Oh, Sam, I'm so proud of you.
Oh, we're both crazy about him.
That's great, but that's not why I'm proud of you.
Okay, why are you proud of me?
Because you married well. I want to have a party. A big one.
A party?
Might be my last chance.
Thank you.
Hey, Trooper, can I come in?
Sure.
Did you have fun with Rosemary today?
It was great.
Want to snuggle? Remember how we always said we'd hope for the best when I got sick?
Yeah.
Well, sometimes the best doesn't happen. And then we have to make other plans. We have to make the best of things as they are. So it looks like the best isn't gonna happen. And if I'm not gonna be around, we're gonna have to find a place for you, Troop.
I don't want to.
I know, baby. But we gotta make the best of things, don't we?
Maybe my dad will come back.
Oh, Troop.
He could.
It's been a very long time.
But he still could, Mom.
But in the meantime, we have to find a place for you where you'll be safe and happy, where people love you and will take care of you. You know Sam and Lydia? They love you very much.
Do you know that? I know it. Do you know how I know it?
Because they said that if anything happened to me, if I didn't get better, that they would love to have you live with them. How would you feel about that?
I don't want to, Mom.
I know, baby. But as long as we're talking about making the best of things, can you think of a place you'd rather be? Do you like them, Troop? I like them very much. In fact, I can't think of anyone I'd rather you be with. Can you?
Can we still hope?
Hope what?
Then you'll get better?
Come here. Yeah. Still hope.
I'm still gonna hope then.
Me too.
This is wonderful.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, for one night only, we present the return of Dee Dee and the Deadbeats. Dee Dee, would you do us the great honor of leading us through our theme song?
Oh, Sam, I'm sorry, I can't.
Oh, come on!
But I want to watch you guys go.
Oh. Now, what's the name of the song?
You Got a Friend.
Oh, I know that.
Get up here!
I'm doing this for you. I love you.
Go get him.
Yay for me!
And we do have a special guest on the drums tonight, Mr. Trooper Michaud.
All right, Trooper!
What key are you guys playing?
What key do you sing it in?
Oh, it doesn't matter. That sounds fine. When you're down and troubled and you need a helping hand, and nothing is going right. Come on, girls. Close your eyes and think of me,
and soon I will be. Brighten up even the darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You've got a friend.
You owe him a bat. That
winter, spring, summer.
Present.
Hey. Oh, that's
gross.
Huge.
Open it!
Just open it, Dee Dee. Come on. Okay. Come on,
rip that sucker open.
All right. Oh. Check that out.
My bike.
Hey. Whoa.
Where'd you find it?
Well, I thought Jimmy Farrington had it, but he'd sold it to Marty and Neil Halfen, and Neil thought Marty had it, Marty thought Neil had it.
Both forgot that they gave it to their little sister, and it was in her basement.
Collecting cobwebs.
But it looks brand new.
Not just a new seat, some fresh paint.
Ah, Troop, this is the bike I rode when I was your age. It's cool. Well, sort of. Excuse me, it's the coolest bike ever. I'm taking it for a ride.
Oh, I hear that. Well, let me help you.
Okay, I got it. All right, now, don't go crazy all at once, you know.
Shut up, you guys.
We'll find a place over here. I put it in first gear, so,
okay.
You know.
Yeah, Ross, easy. I've ridden a bike before.
Okay, well, this is just like that.
All right. Thank you. Oh, okay. Sam, maybe she shouldn't.
You should tell her by now.
Hey, you're Rick.
Hey.
How's the cleanup coming?
It's coming.
I want to start the new construction.
You mean now?
Right away. As soon as you finish with the cleanup.
Well, if that makes sense, Sam. I mean, we'll be caught right in the middle of winter.
Let's take a chance. We might have decent weather.
What if we don't?
We'll shut it down till spring.
But then I'll be left with all this material just hanging around all winter.
It's not gonna hurt it, is it?
Well, I suppose not. What's the hurry?
I'm gonna fill that house up with kids. Thanks, Rick.
Is Liddy pregnant?
No, not yet.
It takes 9 months, you know.
Not always.
Amber's gonna take Chewbacca's brother.
Oh, great, Amber. I'm glad. Are you gonna take him today?
Uh-huh.
Trooper, go bring him in. He'll need a shot.
Okay. Are you gonna do it now?
Yep. Right now.
I'll come back.
Oh, it'll take a minute.
Okay. I hate shots. I'll come back tomorrow.
Trooper, put him up here on the table.
Oh, where's Amber?
Oh, she didn't want to watch.
Yeah, she's not used to this stuff. So just pinch it, okay, puppy?
Pinch. There we go.
You okay?
It's fine.
Here he is.
There.
Huh? What do you think?
Big?
Yeah, come on. You want to feed him?
Sure.
Well, grab a whole lap bucket there. Here we go. Come on out here. Here we go. There you go. Yeah, I'm going to have to have somebody come out and ride him this spring so he don't get too frisky.
I don't suppose you know anyone who'd be willing to do that.
I'd ride him. If I knew how.
You would?
Yeah, if I know how.
Well, now, here you go. I would have thought that he would have done that, would you, Sam?
Never even crossed my mind. But he's awful busy, though. What with being an assistant veterinarian and all.
Oh, yeah, he probably doesn't even have time.
Not much.
Mm. Well, I'd have time. It's just, well, I don't really know how.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. Too bad. Well, of course, there's always Sophie. Yeah, lots of folks learn to ride on Sophie.
Sophie's very gentle.
Oh, very gentle. Sort of like sitting in an easy chair. Well, I'll keep looking. Hey, say, you know, I just got an idea. Now, if you wanted to come and learn on Sophie.
Yeah, I would.
Well, how about that? I think we got a deal. Well, son of a gun, I wish I'd thought of that before. Well, you come on back anytime and we'll get started.
Okay.
Ain't that something?
Yeah, all right, you said.
Never even thought about old Trooper.
All right, 1, 2. Yo, you okay?
Yeah.
Run in. Uh-huh. All right. Ready?
I bet it's the Labor Day picnic.
Maybe. Maybe not.
What's the big surprise, Sam?
It wouldn't be a surprise if I told you. No, would it? What do you think?
Sam, I didn't think that we could...
You took a chance. We've been working overtime. I talked the guys into coming in over the hallways.
Thanks, Rick.
Okay.
All right, you walk the plank.
Thank you so much.
You guys wanted help. They're good guys. Here we have
the
living room, kitchen, bedroom, family room. I wanted you to see it.
Thank you, Sam.
Oh, in case it burns down again.
This be mine?
Be all yours. Do you want to put a bunk bed in here?
Nah. A single?
Whatever you want. I bet you'll be able to have a really nice view of some stars.
Yeah. It's a pretty nice view.
Where at?
Over there. Why don't I see about fixing us some supper?
That'd be great.
Aren't we gonna go to the town picnic?
I don't feel up to it, Troop. I'm sorry. Maybe you and I can stop by later.
That's a good idea. Go into the kitchen and help Lydia. There's some cold spaghetti in the fridge.
Okay.
Okay, go help her.
Yeah. How much of this are you taking?
It's never enough.
You in a lot of pain?
I can manage. Thank you for today, Sam. I owe you so much.
Oh, I don't know about that. I'd say we're pretty even. And I don't just mean when we were kids.
I mean now as well.
You keep showing me how to live my life.
You're doing just fine without me.
It's different without you. You know what? I never told you this. But that night before you left, we were sitting out on your porch.
I know.
What?
You were gonna give me your class ring.
How did you know that?
I just knew. I didn't want to hurt you. You mean so much to me. I love you, Sam. You and Lydia both. Now listen. On that bookshelf, up underneath the basket, there's a letter. Would you get it for me? Come here. I want you to give this to Trooper when you think he's ready. I wrote him a letter about his dad. I always thought he should have a dad he could believe in. He has one now.
Check this out.
There she is. Hey! We figured you couldn't make the picnic, Dee Dee, so we decided to bring the picnic to you.
So we turn to the scripture passages just read, and we look to the memory of Dee Dee Michaud's life for consolation in our sorrow and for inspiration in our lives. And now Dee Dee's son, Trooper, has requested a moment.
When my mom said we were gonna move here, I didn't really want to. 'Cause I didn't really know anybody then. She said that this town was special. And she's told me lots of stories about it. But she said every place we lived was special. So I didn't really believe her. But I like the stories anyways. Now let's see what she meant. Wherever I go, it reminds me of her. It's like she's still here. I'm glad we came. I'm glad.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.